I'm happy somewhat. I've been smiling a lot lately, which isn't something that I'm really used to. Because I'm not the kind of girl who can control what I go through. And some people find comfort in venting about the poison in their bones, but I find no purpose in laying my head on people who already have homes. It does help to know that I have a few there for me whenever I need them. But I'll be living alone when my eyes close and the lights of life turn dim. Even though I'm not tall, I have arms that reach up through the atmosphere. And when they pass the exosphere, I get on my tippy toes and get even more near. The place I'm reaching for is space, where there's no gravity to pull me down. And also, there's just a lot of, well, space to see and explore new things around. But most importantly, there's no oxygen for me to cry, yell, or even speak. All I can do is smile and wait until the air is gone and my lungs are weak. The moral of this isn't that I want to die because life seems to have no worth, but I want to live for something more than the things on this earth. I want to be able to say yes, I reached for the stars and I even grabbed a few. Also, that I went to the moon and back for just an up close and personal view. But for now, I'm stuck here wishing on every star that I see, and those stars mourn for the death of my unborn dreams to be. Because even the brightest sky knows it's destined for darkness. Like, when I'm happy for a period of time, I become visibly anxious, because I don't know when a wave of darkness will wipe out my smile.
Yeah.
I can never genuinely enjoy happiness while I have it for a while. When I look back on life, I'll see the things that got me to where I'll be. And it takes all of this pain to grow and become the opposite of what I see. Life is too precious to worry as much as I do. When you're stuck, learn how to pull yourself through. Because everyone has two shoulders, but only one backbone. Seek good friendships, but don't confide in anyone but yourself alone.
Yeah.